Hey, this is Pat Cox. Welcome to a Magic Origins draft here on Channel Fireball. So opened Gideon's Phalanx, which is a powerful card, but it costs 7, which is a lot of mana. It's really not guaranteed to go to that, and it's also not guaranteed to win the game, like a Karn or some 7-drop that's like totally backbreaking. It's just good. So I don't think that's going to be the pick. It's probably between Acolyte of the Inferno and Suppression Bonds. Acolyte's probably slightly better, but there's a ton of threes in red. Like there's three, you can see one of them here. There's three common red 3-drops that are all pretty good, so it's sort of replaceable. Whereas Bonds is, kind of all white removal, or all the removal that white gets. So yeah, I guess I'll take this, but that might not be great because that person behind me might just take Phalanx, then we fight pack two. Okay, so Rogue's Passage card I'm happy to have in my deck, but not necessarily looking to pick that early. Sky Snare Spider, this card is great. Like I don't really love picking expensive cards early, but this one. And even more so, the 4/6 white guy that taps something, just take over the board on their own. So it's probably going to be this. I mean, if you want to stay in white, we could take Stalwart even, but it's a pretty big step down. I don't really love Celestial Flare. It's fine, but I would certainly take Avon over it. And yeah, Wild Instincts is probably the third best card in the pack after Sky Snare and Avon. I mean, I could see maybe taking Instincts over. I would take Instincts over Avon if not already having a white card. But anyway, Sky Snare Spider is the pick. Okay, so Dark Petition, which is a tutor that gives you mana afterwards. Sorry, I'll put the card previews up, make things a little bigger. Anyway, not a very good card. So, got Trapper, which is good in its. If you're green block elves, but no guarantee you're gonna end up in that. Tactician, perfectly serviceable slash good in a white deck, but nothing that's pulling me into white. So probably the best card in the pack, at least assuming you're not already in a deck like elves. I think it's just Empath. 2/2s are relevant body in the format, like it's gonna trade with something, but you also just get to be up a card and scry. So yeah, I think it's better than Fetid Imp and such. Not a great pack. Okay, wow. So we got Starfish and Void Mage in the pack. It's pretty big indication that blue is open. I guess Starfish is a little better than Void Mage, but man, do I love Void Mage. yeah, I'll take Starfish. I also This guy is just pretty good as like a 2/3 is just a relevant body, even if you don't have other artifacts. This is a good card. Like I will always play this in my deck. It's actually a pretty reasonable early pick just because like it doesn't commit you to anything. But we're pretty clearly seeing there's like three good blue cards in this pack. So I think we can safely say blue's open. So I'll take the Starfish. All right. So Naturalist is great. Anointer is also great, but we're not necessarily. Who knows? Maybe White's open too. This card is conditionally great. It depends on if your deck. It'll be good in any deck, but it's particularly good in a really aggressive deck. Naturalist is just good in any deck. There's two common removal spells that are enchantments. There's a bunch of artifact creatures. Worst case, there's a Thopter. Absolute worst case, a 4/4 is just really good body in the format. So yeah, I think this is. These are kind of close, but I think it's a relatively clear step up here. Ooh, Leaf Gilder. I've been calling this guy Leaf Glider for years. I don't even remember when it first came out, like Lorwyn or something. Ben S actually had the same issue. I don't even know him then, so it wasn't like we like one of us got the other one to say it wrong, but kind of weird. Anyway, I think this is probably the best green common, so. Maybe people disagree with me. It's not an indication that green's open, but green feels pretty open right now. guess we're still not sure about blue. We had that one pack with a bunch of great blue cards, and then not much. Stratuswalk is actually pretty good in blue-green. You can see we have a bunch of big guys, but doesn't necessarily indicate that blue's open. Okay. So we could take a Rogue's Passage, which is not unreasonable. It's like pretty good with all these giant green guys. I really don't love taking that super early. I don't really end up with short unplayables very often in this format, but I also don't want to have this be the time kind of thing. Also, like, you know, Force Mage, while just okay, is also an elf, so we might get some, like, kind of minor elf synergies, like, forget the elf version of this, I forget what it's called, the elf goblin ringleader or something. It could be a reason to have a lot of elves in our deck, is all I'm saying. Okay, foil Shivan Reef. I assume that's not worth very much money, but I have no idea. Either way, Ring Warden Owl is like a pretty reasonable card. I was pretty low on this at first because like 5/5/3 is usually pretty bad, or just mediocre at best. But I think it's actually pretty good in this format. Like, it might end up being cut for my deck, and I'm not even 100% blue, but it is the best card in the pack. All right, I don't like Aeronaut very much. But it might make my deck. Like, if I have, like, some Might of the Masses and stuff, it could be good. And Caterpillar is just a sideboard card that there's not really any, or not many super scary artifacts and enchantments. There's, like, Majoring Responder. I'm missing one or two others, but definitely not, like, where the Sieges were in the format, where you felt like you always had a happen answer. Okay, I mean, this guy's good, not great. I would also be happy enough with the Guardian Automaton here. Well, counters are pretty terrible. And I think actually Veteran Sidearm is pretty decent in the format. I've played it a lot more than I thought I was going to. I might not play in this deck because like in green you actually do have some big guys. But otherwise your guys are pretty small. So, and all the guys are pretty small. So plus one is actually relevant. Aerial Volley is a pretty reasonable sideboard card. Probably don't need a second sidearm. I don't really need either of these things. I guess I still could end up white. That is a reasonable sideboard card. Basically, I would probably side it against like Thopter Spy Network or a deck that had like, you know, three, like a blue-white deck that had just Narcolepsy and Suppression Bonds. Ooh, Abbot of Kara Keep. I have no idea how much that card is worth now. Could see it being a little bit expensive because it won the Pro Tour and / top 8 at the Pro Tour. I don't know how to make that not sound like a humble brag, but anyway, I don't. There's like no way I'm in red, and it's just like it's not actually insane in draft because like a 2/1 on turn 5 or whatever is not that great. You can't construct your deck to have a bunch of ones and twos. Whereas I don't even know what this is called. I thought this was called Into the Aether or something, but Anchored to the Aether, sure. Whatever this is called is pretty great. Sorry, I'm blocking a couple of cards here. Vastwood Gorger, whatever. Screeching Scab, probably not going to be particularly good in my deck, though, you know, it's playable. It's better in, like, a blue-black deck, but yeah, sure, that's what we'll take. Ooh. Well, it's a pretty big payoff. This guy's pretty great. I'm not, like, 100% sure that he's better than Void Mage, because, like, obviously he's not able to be used aggressively, but it doesn't really matter. They're both good. I would be happy to see either one here. I'm pretty sure it's better than Wild Instincts, and there's nothing else in the pack for us, so. Alright. Wow, this is a pretty good pack. So, Jorg Invocation is fine. I actually drafted a really sweet deck with it at the Pro Tour where I had a bunch of, like, Dragon Fodders and Elvish Visionaries, just, like, a bunch of crappy guys that I was just trying to get into play. My deck already had some big guys, so I don't think it's particularly great here. Visionary is a reasonable pick just as another 2-drop, though, you know, we don't have a lot of use for the body. We're not elves. We don't have Might of the Masses, at least yet. So yeah, that's probably the best card in the pack for us is Rock Smallers. I actually have played Zendikar's Royal before, and It is fine if you have like Nissa's Pilgrimage and are like ramping into like a 7 drop or something, but I don't necessarily think you just want to slam it in every deck, and this guy is pretty good, so. Alright. Well, I have yet to actually like try Elemental Bond. It's ended up on my sideboard a few times. This probably is not going to be the time I try it. I'm just pretty sure it's not particularly good. I don't know what the number of threes you need, but or it's probably like 9, 10, I don't know. You know, Empath is probably a little bit better of a card than Timberwatch, Timber Pack, whatever it's called, but we have some fours already, and just having twos is pretty important, so they're close enough that I'm going to take the two. Alright, well, I do like Scab Goliath a lot. It's pretty easy to have him be on immediately. You don't have to have, like, a mill theme. But Void Mage is, I think, just better. So, go ahead and take our Void Mage and be happy. Ooh, Claustrophobia. Yeah, that is what we want. Disperse, it's fine. Like, there's a lot of creatures coming into play effects in the format, so I've definitely had Disperse in my hand and, like, not been able to bounce anything that was in play profitably. Claustrophobia is pretty clearly better regardless of how good Disperse is in any format, but alright. Well, I don't really like Orchard Spirit or Aspiring Aeronaut, but I'll take the one that's cheaper because I got plenty of fours right now. Yeah, Brawler's Plate is, I've never played it, so I could be wrong, but I'm pretty sure it's too expensive to be effective. I don't know if I've ever even seen it played. We're not 100% to play the Stratus Walk, but it could be good in our deck. Like, we got some pretty giant guys, including, like, just turning this guy on is pretty huge. Obviously, they're going to have a hard time blocking it and him not trampling over if they're not just killing it, but Stratus Walk on giant things is pretty good. The best I've done is that Colossus that has Renowned 6. I won the game immediately after. It was great. Alright. So, we can take Screeching Scab, which pretty much sucks. We're going to take Gorger, and you know, if we get more Leaf Gilders, we potentially do want like a couple expensive things. So, I think I'm going to take Gorger. Like, just 2-1s are a pretty big liability in a format where there's all these free Thopters and Dragon Fodder and Elvish Visionary and just all this crap. So, alright, we'll take this as a sideboard card. Alright, well, Elvish Visionary is just much better than Screeching Scab. It trades with all the same crap, but then just not all the same. On offense, all the same, not on defense. But, draws you a card. Drawing cards is great. Alright, so Fairy Miscreant, this is a trap. Pretty much all these things are traps. The white and green ones are good just because they're bears, and bears are good, but don't really try and go into these decks. So I'll take this. Some small chance I play it. Also might side it in a super grindy matchup. Kind of how I feel about Maritime card. Not that it's grindy, but that it's a sideboard card if I played against a deck with a lot of 2-1s that was really aggressive. Alright, well, opened another sweet rare that we can't actually play, so that's cool. Yeah, well, Elite is pretty good. We actually have a decent number of elves in our decks. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 so far, but whatever, it's still just a bear, so pretty low cost to playing this and a pretty nice upside. Yep. Ooh, this pack is insane for us. Wow. Wow. I want like 5 cards from this pack. I even want Might from the Masses, like, or Might of the Masses, whatever it's called. Like, I like that in these decks with like a bunch of twos and, you know, Elvish Visionaries and just crap guys. And then I'd be happy with Leaf Gilder too. Leaf Gilder's great. But Alpha is actually better than both those cards. And Towergeist is better than Alpha. And I'm pretty sure this rare is better than Towergeist, especially in my deck that just has quite a few elves already. So yeah, that's the pick. I mean, I'd be glad if I could somehow table any of that. Can probably table Might of the Masses, but wow, this is a great pack. Alright. Well, could take a second one of these. There is definitely diminishing returns there, but like, is it enough better than Vastwood Gorger? Probably, but could also take an Empath, which is an elf, which is somewhat relevant, but also cost 4. So let's see, we have 1, 2, probably not playing this at least at the moment. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we have an acceptable number of 2 drops. We definitely have some 4s. We wouldn't mind cutting, like, Aspiring Aeronaut. And even Frieza's Disciple. Yeah, I guess I'm gonna take the Wolf. I definitely like erring on the side of my curve being cheaper, but this is actually a pretty hard pack. Like, all these cards are pretty good for my deck. Alright. Yeah, I mean, quite a few pretty good white cards in here. Whatever, we'll take the Recluse and be happy enough. Well, I actually don't know that I'm even playing this Orchard Spirit at this point, so I almost don't know if I want to just take like one of these white cards and just hate it. Eh, I guess I might play it. Like, War Oracle's pretty good. Like, this is already like plenty of cards, and Orchard Spirit's just pretty whatever. That's actually pretty hard. Like, I don't know that I'm super likely to play Orchard Spirit, and this card's a pain in the ass. I guess I'll take the card that could go in my deck. Yeah, so just another Aerial Volley for our sideboard. Well, definitely not playing any of this, so whatever. I guess this is the card that's most likely to be good in someone's deck. Ooh, another Claustrophobia. Well, I'm not gonna play Bone to Ash. Just taking Shrouding Mist, the best card. Wow. Table the Alpha. And I don't even know if that's actually the pick. This card is so good, but I have so few spells that maybe I actually just want the Might. I mean, my deck is going to be the aggressor, and this card is pretty insane when that's the case. So, yeah, I guess it's probably that. Probably just end up cutting some other creatures that are worse. Get out of here, Aspiring Aeronaut, or crap. Guess I'll just take this because I don't want someone to side him against my Claustrophobias. My mana is a little bit awkward. Like, got all these double blue spells, but I guess I only have one double green, but I also just have a bunch of green cards. So if I'm casting two spells on a turn, it's pretty likely they're both green. Probably not playing this Ring Ward now. Just cutting the cards that, like, I don't definitely want. Well, if one Metal Bond is good in my sideboard, then two's good. Pretty sure I want all my twos. Claim is crap and Waltz is good, so might as well take. I guess obviously someone else doesn't think Waltz is good if it's got that far anyway, but. Alright. Okay, I think this is where I'm at with cards that there's some decent chance I play. So, I don't love Vastwood Gorger or Ring Warden Owl. But they're decent, like, curve fillers here. I probably am at least going to play one of them. I could also see not playing the Visionary, but I do have the guy that pumps elves, and there's pretty low cost to that. Stratus Walk, it's probably not going to be super necessary in our deck. Like, we're Got a lot of two drops. This guy is helpful. We got a lot of ways to get rid of blockers. We got two different bounce creatures. So this is probably just not necessary. So we gotta cut one card. Well, if I'm just looking at my curve, this is the card I want the least. That curve looks really good to me. Now, this card's pretty whatever. Maybe I should have taken the other spider, but Wall Spider is a lot better. There are quite a few games where it just doesn't matter. You're just attacking with a big guy, and that wins you the game. I think this is what I like. I could see cutting like a visionary, or that's probably the worst two drop here. No, you can't cut it. You got the elite two. I forgot about that. But anyways, you could potentially play the other four if you got rid of one of the twos, but I don't think that's particularly great. Recluse is not like the best in our deck, but it is just a pretty solid card. And like, we're not super strong against flyers. We have the owl and we have the one reach guy, and I think that's it. Does that have reach? Okay. All right, actually we're fine against flyers. Okay, so let's add some lands. Well, that can't be right. It might be 9/8. Even that is doesn't really make me happy, but that has to be right. Like, really wish I had an Evolving Wilds in this deck. Just like I have so many double blue cards, but there are so few actual blue cards in the deck. I mean, on the plus side, this guy is kind of a four drop, or can be at least. So I guess that kind of helps, like, my curve being a little skewed towards twos, and also by turn four, it's more likely I have double blue. Yeah, I think this is right. This deck seems pretty good.